Okay, this one will make perfect sense. Trust me. This is about angular velocity, okay? We're going to talk about angular speed. What it is, the definition, is the rate at which the central angle is changing. That's not a less than sign, it means angle in this context, okay? So the rate at which the central angle is changing. When we're dealing with a rate, that means we have a ratio, okay? Like kilometers per hour or, I don't know, red Smarties per box. It's some kind of ratio, okay? That's all it is. When you're driving in your car, I know you make it from Peace River to Edmonton in 3 hours flat. If you go somewhere in the neighborhood of 138 kilometers an hour, I've been told this, don't ever do it. You'll get killed by a moose walking in front of you. You won't be able to stop in time. Okay, all it is a rate. It's a rate. Something per something, okay? Per something else. Something per something else. All right. I like my brushes. Okay. So here's a question. Okay, find the angular speed. So this is going to be rate of a wheel that is rotating 15 times in 3 seconds. Perfect. It actually even it tells us what our rate. Okay. So we have 15 rotations per 3 seconds. Could it be any more simple? Not really. Okay. Now what are we looking at here? Angular speed of a wheel. Let's look at this. Okay, here is, you're driving a boat, you're sailing away to Australia. There you are. I don't know, I'm not a boat nut. Okay, so here's your wheel, your captain's wheel, okay? That's you. Wait, you're smiling. Okay, so your wheel is turning 15 times in 3 seconds. It's like you're battling a storm or something, okay? What do we have? When we go around a circle, let's talk radians. Okay, when we go around, that is 2 pi radians, okay? How many rotations is that? That's 1 rotation, okay? Second rotation, we have now gone 4 pi, 2 rotation, okay? We just need to use our common sense that figuring out that if we do 15 rotations, well, 15 times 2 pi will give us 30 pi. Now, symbolically speaking, with math terms, if I go 1 rotation equals 2 pi radians, I could multiply it by 15 on both sides because I'm going to show 15 rotations. And I get 15 rotations equals 30 pi. Okay? This is what they mean when you say symbolically. It's just using the math language and making it look like this, the functions and equations and stuff. Okay, 15 rotations in will be 30 pi in 30 pi radians. Okay, now let's see. We want to find the rate at which the central angle is changing. Okay, when a central angle is changing, okay, there's our central angle. The angle is measured in radians, so it'll be radians per something, maybe per time, okay? How many radians is it changing over an X amount of time? So why don't we set up our ratio like that already? Radians over some kind of time. 15 times in 3 seconds. Our time will be seconds. So some kind of radians over seconds, and let's see what it is here. We are doing it 3 seconds. We have 15 rotations in 3 seconds, but 15 rotations is the same as 30 radians, 30 pi radians, and that's still in 3 seconds. So there we already have it. This is what we were looking for. We have our rate of how many radians per time. Okay. Now, of course, in making any ratio, we want to reduce it down. The grade A stuff here. If I divide just 30 and 3 divide down to 10 over 1, what we get there is 10 pi radians over 1 second. What this means is that find the angular speed of the wheel. Okay, the angular speed of the wheel, the rate at which the central angle is changing is 10 pi radians per 1 second. That's the answer there. Okay. How we got there, I want you to hit pause and rewind if you need to. basically about using common sense to understand that each rotation is 2 pi, a measure of 2 pi, 15 rotations, 15 times 2 pi. Send me an email. I'll gladly remake the video if I need to make it more sense. Sometimes I start to babble. Babble, 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 babble.